Hi guys, I'm Viktorija from Proxies Labs. In today's video, I'll explain how to use public web data to benefit your business. I'll cover various public web data uses for travel, e-commerce, finance, and a couple other industries, so make sure to stick until the end of the video to find out. But first, don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you're interested in all things web scraping. We typically share tutorials along with tips and tricks and discuss various use cases. Let's begin by answering a really important question in web scraping. Can you scrape any data that's on the internet? Essentially, there are two types of data in terms of availability: non-public and public data. If the data is personal or protected by copyright, it is considered non-public and cannot be scraped. If there are no terms and conditions that claim so, the data is considered public and you should be able to scrape it. Of course, it is always best to reach out to a legal professional so they consult you regarding your specific case. Now, let's get into the good part. What are the most common use cases for public web data? So the first one is price monitoring. With online retailers implementing thousands of price changes every day, it will be impossible to track them manually. Meanwhile, automated price monitoring helps e-commerce companies to stay informed about market changes and react in real time. As a result, businesses can optimize their pricing strategies, increase profits, and beat their competitors. Another one is SEO monitoring. Building a solid SEO strategy requires fresh and accurate public data from search engines. Of course, checking how your or your competitor's website ranks with multiple keywords daily would take too much time. That's why web scrapers are widely used in SEO area. With real-time public data delivered from search engines, companies can track their own and competitor rankings to grasp how search engine algorithms work. As a result, they can discover new ways of improving their SEO strategy and get to the top of search engine results pages. The third one is brand protection. Brand and manufacturers always have to be alert about their work being copied and reproduced without consent. The internet is full of counterfeit products and illegally distributed intellectual property, such as music or movies. What's even worse is how easily counterfeits or stolen content multiply and spread across the internet, making it very difficult for brands and manufacturers to protect their work. Here's where web scraping comes to the rescue. You can monitor the web at scale and initiate takedowns as soon as you gather all the evidence. Another common use case is alternative data. Traditional data sources like financial statements and sales numbers do not always show the full picture. That's why many progressive companies turn to alternative data sources like surveys, satellite data, financial transactions, geolocation data, and more. Copy-pasting large amounts of public data from several sources is exhausting, but web scraping is here to make it easy. By monitoring publicly available alternative data, businesses can analyze market tendencies, detect investment opportunities, or study consumer behavior. To give a more specific example, real estate companies can track offerings, home prices, reviews of local businesses, permit, and energy independence data. A really popular use case is travel fare aggregation. The ultimate goal of travel comparison services is to provide travelers with the very best offers. Since pricing and accommodation deals are displayed differently according to your location, it is difficult for these companies to provide accurate information. Hence, they need an easy way to access real-time data from anywhere. Here's where web scraping steps in. It helps to bypass location restrictions, gather accurate data, and present potential customers with the best travel deals. With the help of web scraping, companies also monitor reviews, conduct market research, improve online security, and so on. If you're curious to learn more about each web scraping use case, we have them described on our website in detail. Click the link in the upper right corner. Before we let you go, there's one more thing we need to go through: proxies. Proxies are an essential part of web scraping, especially when it comes to large data quantities. By masking your IP address and changing between IPs regularly, proxies help you avoid various anti-scraping measures. However, there are several different proxy types for individual needs and use cases. We prepared a video explaining different types to guide you through it. Once again, find the link in the upper right corner. If you have any questions about web scraping or our solutions, feel free to contact us at hello@oxylabs.io or simply leave a comment below. And that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to stay updated with the latest web scraping industry news. See you soon!